Okay, so in the last class, am I audible? Please respond. Am I audible, first of all? Please message me, am I audible or not? Right. So in the last class, we have started with DPCM. Okay, so which means D stands for differential. So what is the logic here? We have taken the difference between a sample and its prediction. So this is being quantized and encoded and transmitted over a channel. So what is the reason for this DPCM? So generally, the naturally occurring signals like speech and video, audio, they have a high amount of correlation. They're not independent. They have a high amount of correlation. So we are exploiting this operation, this property. So instead of sampling or quantizing each and every sample, what you're doing? We are taking the difference between a sample X of N and its prediction, that is X cap of N. So this difference is being quantized and correspondingly encoded and transmitted over a channel. Now here, so the problem with DPCM is it is more complicated in nature. Why? Because we need a quantizer, there is a summer, again one more summer, and the up predictor. Okay, so it is very complex structure. The structure is very complex. Okay, so to overcome this complexity, we are going for another type of modulation. So that is called as delta modulation. What it's called as delta modulation. Delta modulation, simply we call DM. So this delta modulation is simplified version of DM is delta modulation is simplified version of DPCM. Just now I told you DPCM is very complex in structure. So to overcome that complexity, we are going for another type of modulation, that is called delta modulation. Okay, so one more thing is, I told you the naturally occurring signals are having high amount of correlation, right? Okay, so if FS increases, what happens? If sample with more rate, what happens? FS increases, that means TS decreases. What is TS? Sampling interval. Okay, so when the gap between, or when the spacing between the samples decreases, okay, what happens? Suppose if the samples are very, very close to each other, very, very close to each other, like this, okay, then what happens? They have more correlation, obviously. Okay, what happens is, so first of all, these signals are having high amount of correlation. Moreover, if sample with more sampling rate, the correlation still increases. Okay, now, so when the correlation increases, what happens? The error decreases. Okay, now, so this idea for delta modulation, what is the idea? So obviously, the naturally occurring signals are having high amount of correlation. They're not independent. That is one more thing. Moreover, if a sample with more rate, the correlation still increases. This leads to decrement in the different signal or error signal. Okay. Now, so as I told you just now, it is a simplified version of DPCM. DPCM is found to be more complex in nature. To overcome that complexity, we are proposing a new method that is called delta modulation. So what changes we will do in delta modulation. Okay, the changes are two. First thing is we use first order predictor. Okay, I told you in the last class what is a first order predictor. It is simply a delay element, Z inverse. If input is x of n, output is x cap of n. That is simply delay element or previous sample. It is a delay. What does this represent? This represent a delay of t how much? Delay of how much? Ts. Okay. So first thing is in DPCM you replace a predictor with its first order predictor, simply a delay element. Next, the second change we do is we use 1-bit quantizer. We use 1-bit quantizer. You know already. So 1-bit quantizer means n equal to 1. You know l equal to 2 power n. L will be equal to how many? 2 means 2-level quantizer. 2-level quantizer. Okay. So in DPCM, we do these two modifications. First modification is replace the predictor with simply a delay element. Replace n-bit quantizer with 1-bit quantizer. 1-bit quantizer, it is also same as 2-level quantizer. Okay, so if you do these two modifications, it is called delta modulation. Now this is a transmitter of DM. DM transmitter. Okay, what you have done? So in place of a predictor, I am replacing with a first order predictor. You know already, the first order predictor means simply a delay element, delay by Ts. It's a 1-bit quantizer having 2 levels. Okay, now, so you know already, so the quantizer having 2 levels means what? What are those 2 levels? So let me go back somewhere. Yes. Yeah. So this is the how many levels are there? 4 level. This is a 2-bit quantizer. What the 1-bit quantizer? How many levels? L equal to 2. Means what? So only 2 levels. How it would be? This one and this one. Correct? Only 2 levels means what? This, this and this. So this one level, this is another level. This is L1, this is L2. It should be symmetric, no? That's why. So below the x-axis one level, above the x-axis one level. Now, so generally, since it is just having 2 levels, what we do here is, what generally we take is, it is something like comparator. What do you say? It is something like comparator. Okay. Yeah. So since it is having 2 levels, it could be like this. Okay. What are those 2 levels? This is one level, positive side, another level, negative side. This is X, this is Y. This is the 1-bit quantizer or 2-level quantizer. Now here, so generally what we say is, we take this as delta. This is minus delta. Okay, it is a comparator. What is this? It is a comparator. What is comparing? If input is positive, it will give you the output as delta. If input is negative, the output is minus delta. It just comparing the input, whether input is positive or negative. Okay. Now, so what we can say is, y is equal to output equal to plus delta if x is positive. It is minus delta if x is negative. Now this is the job of this comparator. So one bit quantizer is nothing but a comparator, okay, with values delta minus delta. Now not only this, yeah, so actually to the quantizer, what is input? E of n. What output? EQ of n. So these are all things already we have discussed for DPCM also. Input is E of n, output is EQ of n. Okay, this is the one bit comparator. Okay, now so it is something like signum function, don't you think so? What is signum function? It is 1 and it is minus 1. Okay, it is signum function. You know all this signum function, but it is, what is this? This is, in the place of 1 we have delta, minus delta. Obviously it is delta of signum function. Okay, now what is the output? Output, that is EQ of n, is signum, delta signum of input. What is input? E of n. Okay, now this is about the one bit quantizer. The quantizer output is delta into signum function of input. Okay, yes, so this is about, yeah, DPCM, and this is DM. In DM, we use first order predictor, which is just a time delay of TS second, sampling period. And we use one bit encoder, one bit quantizer, that is having two levels. Now, basically, DM is one bit DPCM. Okay. So I can say DM is also called as one bit DPCM. Because in DPCM, we are replacing the quantizer with one bit quantizer. Okay, now so next, now how to operate this delta model? It's a transmitter. Okay, now so this portion is called accumulator. This is in the dotted lines is called accumulator. You know what is accumulator? Can you tell me the accumulator equation? You might have studied in your DSP course. Okay, what accumulator? So y of n equal to, or y of n equal to summation k equal to minus infinity to n x of k is accumulator, right? So same thing happens here. This part is known as accumulator. Anyway, so everything is already known to you. So let us write some equation from this transmitter part of the delta modulator. What you can write? Okay. Yeah, this is about, so EQ of n is something like this. Yeah, one more thing I forgot to tell you is, since it is a one bit quantizer, okay, so how to encode? Encoding is only either 0 or 1, because in the code word there is only one bit. Okay, so how to encode? So if the output is delta, we encode is 1, we encode it as a 1. If output is minus delta, we encode it as a 0. Encode it as a 0. Okay. So here the output of the quantizer is, suppose if it is plus delta, we encode it with 1. If it is minus delta, we encode with 0. Okay, that is encoding is also over. Correct? Yeah. So the transmitter, these are the possible equations. Okay. What is EQ of n? Just now I have written. What is EQ of n? It is signum of, sorry, delta signum of E of n. Okay. So from the diagram of transmitter, what you can write still? What is XQ of n? What is XQ of n? Output of the summer. That is XQ of n minus 1 plus EQ of n. Okay. So XQ of n equal to, XQ of n equal to XQ of n minus 1 plus EQ of n. What is E of n? That is error. E of n is x of n minus xq of n minus 1. Okay. So finally, xq of n equal to xq of n minus 1 plus delta signum of E of n. This is very, very important. So finally, the xq of n equal to xq of n minus 1 plus delta sigma of eq of n. So this is the equation which represents dm. It's very, very important. Okay. So what exactly is happening here? So actually xq of n is called staircase approximation. I'll tell you why it is called staircase approximation. It is called a staircase approximation. Okay. Okay. Now, so what exactly happening here? So the xq of n equal to xq of n minus 1 plus some delta sigma of e of n eq of n. Is that it? Now, so here actually, so yeah, just now I told you if e of n is positive, what is eq of n? Delta. If e of n is negative, what is eq of n? Minus delta. So here we are just comparing the error, whether it is positive or negative. Okay. Suppose simply if error is positive, if the difference is positive, what happens to the xq of n? Xq of n equal to xq of n equal to xq of n minus 1 plus delta. Why plus delta? Because if error is positive, eq of n is what? Delta. Simply get delta. Okay. Next. If the error is negative, what is xq of n? Obviously, it is minus delta. That means xq of n minus 1 minus delta. Now, so this is the logic of delta modulation. So we are just comparing whether the error is positive or negative. Okay. So suppose this is xq of n. This is xq of n minus 1. So if it is a present value, this is a past value. If it is a present sample, it is a past sample. Okay. Now what happens is, if the error is positive, what happens? The present sample, the present value will be incremented by delta. Why? Because to the past value, we are adding delta. What happens now? The present value will be incremented by delta. If the error is negative, what is happening? To the present value, we are adding minus delta. To the past value, we are adding minus delta. Means the present value will be decremented by delta. Okay. So it is very, very simple. We take the error. If it is positive, okay, the sample value will be incremented by delta. If it is negative, the value will be decremented by delta in the next sample. Okay. So that is simple logic. What you written here is, if the error is positive, the approximated signal, what is the approximated signal? It is called as approximated signal. Staircase approximated signals is called as xq of n. Now, so that will be incremented by one step, that is delta. Okay, what is delta? Step size of the quantizer. Obviously, this is output. If the error is negative, the approximated signal is reduced by delta. This is the output. Okay. Now, obviously, so when it is less delta, okay, here, so if the error is positive, so xq of n is incremented by delta, and correspondingly, it is encoded as 1. Why? Because we are getting plus delta as a quantizer output. Now, if error is negative, it is decremented by delta, it is encoded as obviously 0. okay, 180, 180. Now, so this is how we do the delta modulation process. So if the step is reduced, zero is transmitted. If step is increased, one is transmitted. So in delta modulation, we get a staircase approximated waveform. Okay, with step size delta. So I told you already how would be the staircase approximation, something like this. The DM output would be something like this. Okay, staircase approximation. What it is called? The staircase approximation. It's just like a stairs or steps, something like this. Now the output quality of waveform is moderate. Why it is so, we'll discuss. Now this is the output of the delta, not output, actually this x of t, and this is, I've written u of t, but it is actually x q of t. U of t, we have written u of t to indicate a staircase approximation. Why staircase? What is u of t actually? It is all something like staircase, no? How would u of t would be? Something like this. This is the unit step. Okay, so this is the x of t, this is xq of t. I'm writing t only, okay, because it is somewhat continuous step, not n. Okay, no problem. What exactly happened here? Actually, we are, this is the x of t, the solid line. Okay, now, so first of all, this is the first output, xq of t. We take error. If error is positive, we increase by delta. Okay, here this is delta, this height is delta. Okay, so we compare error. If it is positive, increase by delta. But how to encode it? Using one, because if it is plus delta, if it is increasing means plus delta. What is the corresponding bit? 1. Okay, again we compare error, again positive, we increase by delta, again positive, increase by delta, again positive, increase by delta, increase by delta, increase by delta, something like this. At this point, so if it is increasing means always 1. At this point error is negative. What we decrease by delta. So here it is 0. Okay, so again, something like this. Actually, so these bits are not properly written. Please take care of it. So whenever it is increment by delta, you add plus 1, it is 0 otherwise. They are not written properly. Okay, you take care of this. This is not correct. Okay, now, so what is the aim of the delta modulator? It is trying to follow the input waveform. What is trying to follow? The staircase approximation. Okay, you can observe here. Actually, this is the original waveform. Okay, this is staircase waveform is trying to follow the original waveform. Okay, what do you mean by this? Suppose this is input signal, something like this. Okay, so with the delta modulator, we try to follow the input waveform with the staircase approximation, like this. Okay, so if input is like this, our staircase signal should be like this. We always try to follow the original signal. So this is x of t and this is xq of t. The staircase function is xq of t. Xq of t tries to follow x of t. Okay. Yeah. So this is a receiver, obviously. So the receiver, we use same accumulator that is used in the transmitter. So everything is same. What is input here? What is output? Input to the demodulator is, this is a receiver. Okay. What is the input? EQ of N. What is input? Because what is the output of this delta modulator? Transmitter output is what? EQ of N. So that would be input to the receiver, obviously. Okay, So what do you written here? Yes. Okay. What is this x q of n minus 1? Everything would be same. This is x q of n. Now what is output now? This is what is now x q of n. Output of this receiver will be x q of n. We passed low pass filter to eliminate or to smoothen the curve. So the low pass filter smoothens the staircase signal to reconstruct the original message signal x of t. Receiver is very simple. Okay. Now here, so what is e of n? Error signal or different signal from the transmitter part? What is e of n? It is x of n minus x q of n minus 1. X of n minus x q of n minus 1. X of n minus x q of n minus 1. So the error signal is x of n minus x q of n minus 1. Simply, in the delta modulator, we are transmitting the difference between two successive samples. Almost, we are just transmitting the error between two successive samples. Suppose this is the first sample, this is the second sample. We are transmitting this error, this difference. Not exactly, but similarly like that. X of n minus 1, x q of n minus 1. Okay. Now, so here the difference between two successive samples is being quantized and transmitted over a channel. That is delta modulation. In DPCM, what do? We transmit the difference between a original sample and its prediction. If this is x of n, this is x cap of n. That is the estimation of x of n or prediction of x of n. Okay. Here, there is no prediction at all. What is the prediction? Just we are taking the previous sample. First order predictor means just delay element. Okay. Now, so here what I want to say is the modulated signal carries information not about the samples but about the difference between successive samples. Right? We are not modulating the samples. We are modulating the difference between two successive samples. DM carries information about the derivative of m of t, hence the name delta modulation. Why derivative? So difference is nothing but derivative in continuous time. So in discrete time, we call difference. We call first backward difference, something like that, right? Suppose if you take x of n minus 1, it is called first backward difference. Okay. Now, if you go in continuous time, it would be something like difference or differentiation. Okay. Since the delta modulation carries information about the difference of the samples, it is called delta modulation. Because, so derivative is nothing but delta, no? Suppose dx of dt is nothing but delta x of t by delta t. Something like this, okay? It's called delta. That's why it's called delta. Because it carries about the derivative of x of t, not about x of t. Yes. Yeah. So now we have some problems with delta modulation. The drawbacks of delta modulation. Okay. So delta modulation is little bit simpler in the structure. Why it is simple? We made it simple by replacing this predictor with first order predictor. It's a primitive predictor. And not only that, we have made it simple by replacing a quantizer with 1-bit quantizer. Or two level quantizer. It is less complex compared to DPCM at least. Okay. And so the quality will be moderate, obviously. Okay. Find out the reason why the quality of this DM is moderate. Now, so let us go to the drawbacks of delta modulator. The first drawback is called slope overload distortion. slope overload distortion or noise. The second one is called granular noise. These are two drawbacks of delta modulation. So it is similar to the quantization noise. It is similar to the quantization noise. Okay, so the granular noise is just like the quantization noise. So let us discuss one by one. What is slope overload distortion? Okay, so let us take this. First of all, let us find out this slope overload distortion, granular noise, also called as similar to the quantization noise. If x of t changes too fast, xq of t cannot follow x of t. Okay, here what is happening? Here x of t is changing very fastly in this segment of the x of t. It is changing rapidly, it is increasing rapidly. This is x of t. But xq of t, the staircase approximation, unable to follow x of t. Okay, what is happening here? Since x of t is increasing fastly, it is rapidly increasing, but the staircase approximation is unable to follow this x of t. This is x of t, this is xq of t. Ideally, xq of t should follow x of t, but it is unable to follow it. Why? Because it is varying, it is increasing fastly, but it is not increasing that fastly. Okay. Now, the step size delta becomes too small for staircase signal xq of t to follow steep segment of x of t. Why it is unable to follow? Here the step size, no? This is step size. It is small. That's why it is unable to follow. Okay, you understand the logic. So suppose if this step size is large, what would have happened? Okay, what would have happened? Observe very carefully. If the step size is large, it would have happened like this. It would have followed x of t. Okay, so with the given delta, it is unable to follow x of t. Understand my point very carefully. Don't get confused. Okay, so what I want to say is, with the given delta, whenever x of t is changing very fastly, this xq of t is unable to follow it. That's why there is a gap. This gap is called as slope overload distortion. It is called as slope overload distortion. Okay, why is occurring? It is occurring because the slope of x of t is more than the slope of xq of t. Okay, see, if x of t is increasing very fastly, means its slope is more. That is simple meaning. Okay, so increasing or decreasing, it could be both. Yeah, it could be reverse also. No, suppose let me take one more example. Suppose if it is falling very fastly, something like this, it is called steep segment. If something is increasing very rapidly or decreasing very rapidly, it is called steep segment. Okay, so here also what happens? The xq of t may not follow x of t. Why? Because here the slope of x of t is more than the slope of xq of t. So it is because of slope variations. That's what is called slope overload distortion. Okay. So what is the remedy? which means how to overcome this distortion? You increase delta. If you increase delta, what would happen? Suppose you take here, this is delta. If delta is more, what would happen here? I told just now. So this height would be more, something like this. So there are chances that it could have followed x of t. If delta had been more, xq of t would have followed x of t. Now, so this is one problem. So this gap is the distortion. That is called slope over distortion. Yeah. Unfortunately, this increases the granular noise. If you increase delta, okay, you get one more problem, granular noise. Okay, so I don't want to confuse you just now. So we have one problem that is called slope over distortion. For that, we have to increase delta. Okay, remember this. This is the first solution. This is the solution for the first problem. You understood this distortion? Whenever x of t increases so rapidly, then xq of t unable to follow it. So then there is a gap that is called slope overload distortion. The reason for this is the slope of x of t is more than slope of xq of t. The local slope, we can say otherwise. The local slope of x of t is more than slope of xq of t. Okay, furthermore, what about the xq of t? As I told you, it is a staircase approximation, something like this. It is steps. What is the slope of the signal? Okay, or before that, yeah, this is Ts. The width is Ts, height is delta. Okay, remember this. Here, this is Ts. But this height is delta. What is slope? Slope of xq of t is what? What is that? Slope means generally what you write? Y by x, isn't it? Suppose this is a step we have. This width is Ts, this height is delta. I'm taking only one step, something like this. It would be something like this. What is the slope of this? We say that y by x, no? I mean, that is delta by Ts. So, slope of xq of t, that equal to delta by Ts, that equal to delta into Fs. Why? Because 1 by Ts is nothing but Fs. Now, so anyway, slope depends upon delta as well as Ts. Ts, we cannot change it. Okay. Only thing is we can change delta, which means, so if you increase delta, slope increases. That's why, what is the remedy? So the reason is the slope of x of t is more than slope of xq of t. How to overcome this? You have to increase the slope of x of t. How to increase slope of x of t? By increasing delta. That's why the remedy is, or the solution to this problem is, increase delta. But actually what happens? If you increase delta, the slope of xq of t increases. It may be equal to x of t sometimes. Okay, you got my point? Right. Now, so here, that is one problem, we got remedy. So when it occurs, how to overcome it? Okay, now, yeah, so let us discuss detail about this. Yeah, this is, no overload occurs if, yeah, So when it occurs now. When it doesn't occur, reverse. No overload occurs. Okay. No overload. When? Tell me when. So slope of xq of t. Okay. Slope of xq of t is more than slope of x of t. Please remember, it is no overload. So the problem is, I have shared the PPT, no? There it is written overload only. There is a mistake. Okay, don't confuse. So what I'm saying is, I have shared a PPT, no? In that is written only overload, but it should be no overload. There is a mistake. Okay, take care of it. Obviously, slope of xq of t we know. That is what? Delta Fs should be greater than slope of x of t. Generally, x of t is, you know, continuous time signal. Slope would be what? Generally, we take differentiation. Mod of x dash of t is nothing but slope. How to find the slope of signal x of t? Take differentiation. Okay, so it would be simply become what is the condition for no slope overload? Delta Fs should be greater than mod x maximum. Okay, I'm taking a special case. If x of t is, let us take a cos omega t. X of t is a cos omega t. What is x dash of t? Means differentiation of x of t. What is that? A omega cos becomes sin. I'm not writing plus or minus. Okay. What is mod of this? A omega. Okay. Maximum also A omega. Now then what is the condition? Delta Fs should be more than that, which means, so Delta Fs should be more than A into omega, or A into omega should be less than Delta Fs. This is a condition for no slope overload. Now, what is A? A is the amplitude of this x of t. What is A? It's amplitude of x of t. Obviously, so what is the maximum value of A? Would be equal to, so Delta Fs by omega. This is omega. So the maximum amplitude of x of t for no slope overload distortion is Delta Fs by omega. What is omega? It is a angular frequency, that is 2 pi into Fm. Okay, so you should know this. I give you one problem, you solve it. This is a gate problem. Okay. Okay, so that is about slope overload distortion. Now let us move on to the granular noise. Okay, what is that? Granular noise. The second drawback of delta modulation is what? Granular noise. Okay. So what about granular noise? Let us discuss this also and then we wind up. So let me explain here itself. Yeah, here, whenever the input waveform is having some slow variations, okay, or it is some, whenever it is relatively flat, you can see here it is having flat curve, somewhat flat. Whenever the input waveform is having a flat curve, the output waveform is oscillates between plus or minus delta. It is alternative to plus or minus delta. What do you mean by that? You are getting plus delta. It is minus delta, again plus delta, again minus delta, again plus delta. So it is oscillating between plus or minus delta. You are getting alternatively plus or minus delta. So it is similar to the, I told you, quantization noise. Okay, so let me write here. What is happens here is whenever the input waveform is having relatively slow variations, or whenever it is relatively flat, okay, so what happens is the output waveform is oscillates between plus or minus delta. Okay, this is plus delta, this is minus delta. Whenever the input waveform is relatively flat, or whenever it is having some small variations, okay, the xq of t is oscillates between plus or minus delta, then this is called granular noise. It is similar to the quantization noise. So this difference, is called a granular noise. So shows that input signal is almost flat. The staircase signal keeps on oscillating by plus or minus delta around the signal. Okay, so around the signal, it keeps on oscillating between plus or minus delta, isn't it? This is the original signal. Around the signal, it is oscillating between plus or minus delta around x of t. It is analogous to the quantization noise in PCM. What the solution to this problem is, you should make the step size small. What will happen if I make step size small? Suppose if I make step size small, what will happen? Here step size is not small. Okay, if the step size is small, what will happen here is very small compared to like this. It won't oscillate. You get something like this. You may get oscillations, but not that many oscillations. Something like this. Something like this. Okay. So the important thing to remember is, what's the problem? If it is oscillating between, if it oscillates around x of t, what's the problem? The problem is, we will miss the small variations. The small variations will not be captured. Okay, so whenever it oscillates, the small variations will not be captured. Okay, here what is happening? So if it doesn't oscillate around x of t, we can also capture the small variations in the x of t. That is the problem. Okay, we can capture small variations also. Okay, if there is a granular noise, we cannot capture the small variations. If there is no granular noise, we can capture those small variations. Okay, now how to overcome granular noise? By decreasing delta, the second remedy, second solution. Okay, now here we have a conflict of interest. What is that? The remedies are, the solutions are conflicting each other. Okay, first, for slope overload distortion, what is the remedy? Increase delta. For granular noise, what is the remedy? Decrease delta. Okay, which means we cannot eliminate both drawbacks at a time simultaneously. Why? Because delta is fixed. Delta is fixed actually. Okay. If you keep delta sufficiently large so that this will be eliminated, but what happens? You get second problem. If decrease delta, second problem may be eliminated, but you get first problem because the solutions to these problems are contradicting each other. If increase delta, you may overcome first problem, but you get second problem. If decrease delta, you may overcome second problem, but you get first problem. Okay, so that is a drawback of delta modulation, which means you cannot eliminate both at a time. Either you can eliminate slope overload or granular, but you cannot eliminate both at a time or simultaneously. What is the reason? Because the solutions to these two problems are contradicting each other. We have a conflict of interest. Okay. Now, so the solution to the problem is, what is the solution to the problem? So we have to compromise between slope overload and granular noise. We have to compromise between these two. What is compromisation? So we have to compromise such that both will be eliminated to the maximum extent. Not completely, may not be completely, but both could be eliminated considerably. Okay. So we have to choose delta such that both these distortions could be eliminated considerably. Okay. Now, so obviously, delta should not be fixed. Delta should not be fixed. If it is fixed, we cannot eliminate both problems. So delta should be adaptive in nature. Delta should be adaptive. So this lead to, the step size is variable according to the input signal in ADM, whereas it is fixed in delta modulation. Okay, so delta is adaptive to what? Adaptive to x of t. Okay, so we could able to change delta depending upon the x of t, otherwise slope of x of t. Okay, now what is solution? The step size is made variable. Please study this very carefully. Such that it is enlarged or increased during the interval when slope overload distortion is dominant. Whenever we get a slope overload distortion, we increase delta because that is a remedy for the distortion. I told you already. Okay. So what happens? Suppose if 1 bit quantized output is 1, then the step size may be increased for an example. I will explain this later. And reduce the step size when the granular noise is dominant. Okay, so what they want to say is, so suppose if I draw like this, something like this. Now, so the problem with the delta modulation is something like this, correct? Something like this. So here delta is fixed. Now, so in ADM, that is adaptive delta modulation, obviously the name itself suggests that it is adaptive to nature, adaptive in nature. So what they want to say is, whenever slope overload distortion is dominant, increase delta. Okay, in this portion, in this steep segment of x of t, what is dominant? We have a slope overload distortion. Then what we do? We increase delta. This is in the first region. In the second region, what is dominant? Granular noise. So whenever this is dominant, we decrease delta. Simply, delta is variable now. It is not constant or not fixed. It is varies according to the x of t. According to x of t. According to slope of x of t. More precisely. Okay. Now, obviously, the problem is solved. Okay. So, whenever there is a slope over a distortion, we increase in delta, that could be eliminated. Whenever this is more, we decrease delta, this also could be eliminated. Okay. In this way, we are compromising between both distortions and we are trying to eliminate both distortions to the maximum possible extent. This is done by ADM. In ADM, delta is variable, not fixed. In DM, delta is fixed. Since delta is fixed in DM, we could eliminate either first problem or second problem, but not both problems at a time. Okay. So here, what is the logic here? Yeah, this is ADM. This is ADM. Okay, the extra term is we have a logic circuitry for step size. Okay, we take feedback. Suppose output is 1. Output is 1 means it is high, isn't it? When output is y, output is 1 means it is increasing. Here, if you take the bits, you get 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1, something like this. If the output is 1 means it is increasing actually. Okay. If the output is 1, what happens now? The logic circuit will get that it is increasing. So then what it will do? It will ask this quantizer to increase the step size. Okay. When the output is 0, it takes the feedback from the output. When the output is 0, it will ask this quantizer to decrease the step size. Okay, how it works? Let us take an example. Okay, so the extra thing is only we have a logic circuitry for controlling the step size. Obviously, here we need to control the step size. Okay, so when your output is 1, okay, it will increase the step size for the next sample. Okay, that is the meaning. If output is 0, it will decrease the step size for next sample. Okay, everything is same, all are same. Delay element, sum are everything same. This is only extra. Now, what is happening here? So here, output is 1. Okay. Now we are for the next sample, we are increasing delta. Again, output is 1. For next sample, we are increasing delta even more. Okay. So when output is 0, we are decreasing delta. When output is 1, we are increasing. When output is 0, we are decreasing the delta. Okay. So with this, we could able to avoid both problems to the maximum possible extent. I am not saying completely. Okay. Here, this is delta 2. This is delta 1. So you got something like this. This is delta 1. This is delta 2. Now delta is not fixed. Delta 2 is more than delta 1. Okay. So in this way, we could able to avoid the problems to the maximum possible extent. So the slope overload and granular noise errors which are present in the delta modulator are not seen in this modulation, in this adaptive delta modulation. Okay, right. So any doubts you can ask me, otherwise stop here. Okay, right. So we stop here. Thank you.